ugly outside.
Audi. Quattro.
Audi with Quattro all-wheel drive. Track one down at a dealer near you.
Use MSN to get online. Use it to plan a fishing trip. Use it to buy a graphite fishing rod. And hand-tied flies. And searching for basic fishing techniques might be really useful, too. Want an internet service you can really use? MSN from Microsoft is the great alternative to AOL. MSN, more useful every day.
Now, from Evening Edition, here's your local forecast, always on the 8s of every hour.
Currently in your area, 27 degrees, with light snow. Expect fair skies Monday through Wednesday with temperatures in the 40s on Monday.
Watching the Weather Channel. Live by it. Live. You're watching the Weather Channel. Evening Edition.
Start spreading the news. It was snowing tonight, and you're all a part of it here in New York, New York. Find out how long the wintry weather is going to stick around, my friend, coming up.
Dave, I gotta love that singing. This is Mike Seidel in Washington tonight. We're getting a little snow now. We've had sleet, we've had freezing rain and rain. We'll talk about how our day was today and what we can look forward to tomorrow here in Washington.
The eastern half of the nation will either be digging out or drying out on Sunday, but the weather will become active in the Pacific Northwest tomorrow. A new storm rolls in off the Pacific, which means, well, healthy shot of snow or rain. Hello? And welcome to the Weather Channel Evening Edition. I'm Lisa Moser.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Good to see you tonight, my friend. Well, after playing cat and mouse with the big cities in the Northeast, old man winter has come roaring out of retirement tonight. And he's giving everyone from D.C. to Philly and New York City and Boston a first significant snow since last year. Let's peek into my old hometown of Philadelphia, where we dusted off the cobwebs off of our snow shovels and got down to business. The snowflakes started to fall this morning. Our weather friends here could end up with 4 or 5 inches by the time all is said and done. Washington, D.C. and New York City have also seen some pretty good snow bursts today. We've sent a team of meteorologists out to cover this storm. Our Jeff Morrow of Pennsylvania is braving the snow in New York City tonight. And Mike Seidel is in Washington, D.C. It's a snowy job, but someone has to do it. Jeff, let's start with you first. What's it like?
I don't know what was worse, Dave, listening to that opening serenade or standing in the snow. I guess it was the snow. Actually, it hasn't been all that terribly bad here. It's the weekend, obviously, and most New Yorkers that we've talked to here are actually having a pretty good time with the snow. Some folks that are visiting could maybe rather do without, but hey, it comes with the territory, although, as you were mentioning, not so much this season because we really have not had very much snow at all. A half inch up until this storm. Now we're talking about 2 to 3 inches on the ground, and we may end up with about 4, 4.5 before it's all said and done later on this evening. We have a little bit of a different perspective. Want to show you the roadway here and see how things are shaping up. You can see on the side of Columbus Circle here, there is some slush, but out where the main taxis and the cars and buses have been moving, the roadways are just wet, and that is pretty much the deal through much of the five boroughs here. So just take it easy if you're out and about. Sidewalks are pretty treacherous, but we're not the only city that's had some snow. Down the coast a ways toward the nation's capital, we've seen some snow as well. Here's Mike Seidel.
Hey, Jeff, much like in New York, we have not had much snow at all this season, only a trace so far officially at Reagan. Today we picked up 3 inches, but we've got some catching up to do. The seasonal average is 18.5 inches, so we're still running a deficit in the snowfall column. Let me take you back to about mid-afternoon. It came down pretty hard between about 1 and about 2 o'clock. That was our heaviest snowfall, although it started around 9 this morning. And some pretty scenes down here in the mall between the Capitol and the Washington Monument. And the snow really brought out some people playing in the snow, snowball fights, making snowmen, and just enjoying the pretty pictures and taking in some of the sights. And also the museums like the Smithsonian Air and Space and the gallery, both having some decent crowds considering how the weather was. Roads here, much like in Washington tonight, are just wet. They're not icy, they're in pretty good shape. And over the past 15 or 20 minutes, we've had the sleet and rain change over to some big wet snowflakes. We don't expect much more for the rest of the weekend. Sunshine tomorrow, 40 or 41, and the upper 40s on Monday. So quick melting, and we'll see the ground again, if not by late tomorrow, certainly on Monday. Could be more snow in here late next week. We'll keep you posted on that one. Dave, sing it to us, buddy.
Thank you, babe. I'll see what I can do. Mike Seidel in Washington, D.C. Now it's time to bring in our winter weather expert, Paul Kosin. Now, he's the man who's been tracking this storm since it was just a sparkle in our meteorologist's eyes. So what's the word tonight, Paul?
Well, Dave, it looks like we're getting our last gasp of snowfall across portions of the Northeast, and we'll see that snow come to an end. Washington, Baltimore, Philadelphia, generally within the next 1 to 2 hours. New York City, your snow has lightened up, but you'll see the snow come back for a few hours. That will then taper off as well. Let's take a look at the radar. Here's our low pressure system right now off the coast. Tricky little storm for something that initially looked a little straightforward. One burst of snow moved across the mid-Atlantic states today. Then it petered out, and then a second burst of snow came, and we're now seeing the end of that coming across the region right now. So looking at the significant snow, just changed over to snow back in Washington. We'll see the snow coming across Philadelphia, but this is going to be moving fairly rapidly towards the east, so only about an hour or two up towards Philadelphia, and probably less than that in the Washington metropolitan area. Little breaks around the New York City area, but we're still seeing some of that light to moderate snow coming back to the west. And across southern New England, that's where we're going to see significant accumulations overnight on the order of about 3 to 6 inches of snow. And we'll see that snowfall continuing till about 2-3 o'clock in the morning, ending in midnight, New York City. Dave?
So anything but a crippling snowstorm, and it's during the weekend.
It's sort of a nice way to spend Saturday night.
Paul Kosin, our winter weather expert, thanks so much. Well, not only is snow a factor along the East Coast due to the same storm, but rain, too. Here's the East Coast view of our storm. You notice the white, that's all the snow coming to an end in West Virginia. But across Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, and Georgia, rainfall has just been tremendous. Now, this morning, we started off in Richmond with heavy snow. Boy, about 11 or 12 o'clock, it was coming down. Then the warmer air streamed in, and we've got rain of 95 from D.C. southward all the way into North Carolina, as a matter of fact. Reports of light sleet, that's just about it. This storm is coming to an end here over the Blue Ridge Mountains. But boy, if you live in Norfolk, you're getting the rain big time. New Bern now, Raleigh, significant rain today. Temperatures in the 30s all day. Greensboro and Charlotte in the 30s, a nasty start to the weekend. But I'll tell you, our friends here in South Carolina and Georgia and parts of North Carolina, too, are thrilled to see this kind of rain. Atlanta, Georgia, you haven't had that much rain in one day since last June the 1st. Clemson with 2 inches. Rome, Georgia with 2 inches. Now that rain is tapering off. As the cold front blows through, a little secondary trough goes through. It's turned windy after a high temperature today of 61. It's really cooled down. Meanwhile, we were in the 80s in Florida. And good news for you, the front stalls out. Another warm day, Orlando to Miami. Sunshine back out in Birmingham and Nashville. Lisa?
Very mild temperatures across the midsection of the country, a little above average today in Chicago, Indianapolis, St. Louis, currently looking at 29 in Chicago. Some colder air trying to come a little further south.
Leather.